So hello everyone, my question today is how can we make CNNs more adaptive in terms of performance? I'll present to you our band-limited training and inference for CNNs. So my name is Adam Dziedzic and I'm from University of Chicago. This is joint work with John Paparizos, Sanjay Krishnan, Aaron Elmore and Michael Franklin. So natural images and in general natural data are biased towards lower frequencies. On the left hand side, we show a natural image in the spatial domain. On the right-hand side is the same image, but in the frequency domain. We can go back and forth between these two different domains using Fourier transformation and its inverse. We also show on the right-hand side how we can compress the image in the frequency domain, in this case by 50%. Our main contribution is a method for convnets to constrain the frequency band in convolution operation, and we are focused on efficiency, but also we want to leverage the properties of frequency domain. And to show on the right-hand side how we can compress the image in practice by 50%. So FFT-based convolution for convnets was proposed first by Mathieu et al., and then it was refined by Vasilash et al. So how does it work? We have as inputs data X and filter Y. We apply FFT to go to the frequency domain. In the frequency domain, we execute element-wise multiplication, which is convolution, and then we go back to the spatial domain using inverse Fourier transformation and return output that is data X convolved with filter Y. However, the main problem with this algorithm is that it uses substantial memory workspace. So the question is, how can we do better? In our work, by band limiting, we define masking out high frequencies. In the red boxes, we indicate where we band limit data X and filter Y in the frequency domain. We discard high frequency coefficients. So in the red boxes, we use less memory. Next, because we have fewer coefficients, they require fewer multiplications, and we can accelerate the multiplication indicated in the green box. Additionally, we have to make sure that we preserve enough of the spectrum so that our models can retain high accuracy. What is our band limiting technique? Let's imagine that we have FFT input map. And because of conjugate symmetry, we can discard almost half of these coefficients and they can be reconstructed from values in white. Next, we have real value constraints. And we make sure that during our compression decompression, we maintain these values as real values. There are no constraints for values in blue. However, if you want to fully recover this FFT map, you have to preserve the yellow and blue values. Our compression is lossy, and we start from removing the high frequency coefficients. The first layer of compression is indicated in the red boxes. We remove this first layer of compression. If we want to compress more, then we remove data that is in green boxes. And we proceed in this fashion, starting from the corners and going towards the center of the FFT map. What is the impact of band limiting on accuracy? Here we present on the y-axis test accuracy from 85 to 95%. On the x-axis, we systematically increase the compression rate from 0 to 80%. Our model is ResNet 18, trained on CIFAR-10 data. For the full spectra model without any compression, our accuracy is 93.5%. If you compress our model in the frequency domain by 50%, our accuracy drops slightly to about 92%. We observe similar trends for other datasets and models. We also present result here for DenseNet 121 model, which was trained on CIFAR 100 data. What are the main takeaways from our band-limited CNNs? So we propose a method to constrain the frequency band in convolution operation. Our models integrate gracefully, and we have this tuning knob that we can sacrifice slightly the accuracy for a better performance in terms of faster computation or lower memory usage. And we observe that during training, low frequencies are learned first, and to get the best accuracy, we have to apply the same compression during both training and inference. We also found that our band-limited models are robust to some attacks, in this case, black box attacks. For example, if adversary injects Gaussian or uniform noise, then we can reject this noise and recover the correct label. Finally, our method is applicable to other domains, such as time series and speech data. Thank you very much and please come to my poster session. ID is 132.